What's up, friends? Fellow card collectors, Card Hobbyist here, and today we're going to be doing a Binder Bites for Hall of Fame Binder. We're going to start moving through these. I'd mentioned before, I like doing the Binder Bites better than the longer Binder videos because it's just, I don't know, less work, I guess. A little more work editing, but a little less work as far as like getting set up to record and all that. But yeah, so today we're going to be doing another Binder Bites. We're going to do one player. This player was born in 1958 in Garden Grove, California.
We took this trip to Garden Grove. Smelled like Lou Dog inside the van. Oh yeah.
Made their major league debut in 1977. Was elected to the Hall of Fame in 2018. Have you guessed the player yet? I'll give you another hint. Spent 19 years as part of one double play combo up in Detroit. This shortstop played 19 seasons with Sweet Lou Whitaker. You should have guessed it by now if you are a Hall of Fame fan. But in case you didn't, we are talking about Mr. Alan Trammell. Alan Trammell. Let's get the focus right and go through these cards real quick. Okay, starting off, we got a 1996 Collector's Choice, followed by a 1997 Collector's Choice. And then we got an 87 Donruss here. Love 87 Donruss, one of my favorite sets of the 80s. 88 Donruss bonus MVP card, followed by the regular 88 Donruss. And then we move on to 89 Donruss bonus MVP. And then the regular 89 Donruss. And then the 1990 Donruss bonus MVP, another Donruss bonus MVP, and you may wonder why I have two in here. Some of you may collect them, some of you may not, but you got the dot and the no dot versions. This one is the no dot version, this one is the dot version. All that's different is a little dot between the INC, or at the end of the INC and Leaf Incorporated. There's actually a third variation. Or, I don't know, there's like a fourth variation, I think, as well, on 90 Donruss. I don't know. Whenever I add a card to Trading Card Database, because it asks if it's a dot or no dot, I add it. You know, I don't really seek out the dot, no dot variation. When I come across one, I'll keep it, you know. All right, next up, we got a 1991 Donruss, Alan Trammell. And then we got a 2020 Donruss yellow parallel, followed by a 2020 Donruss regular retro design. And then we got a 1982 Fleer here, Alan Trammell, followed by a 90 Fleer, followed by a 85 Fleer limited edition, followed by an 87 Fleer mini, followed by a 2006 Greats of the Game. And then a 2013 Hometown Heroes. All right, here we got a 1992 Leaf, followed by a 92 Pinnacle, followed by a 95 SP, and then a 96 SP, 96 Stadium Club, and then we got 83 Tops, 88 Tops. This is 88 Tops All-Star. And then 89 Tops All-Star. And this is the last page of Alan Trammell cards I got. We got a 1989 Tops, 91 Tops, a 1989 Ames. This was also produced by Tops. Ames 2020 Club. We got a 2020 Tops Archives, 1988 Rite Aid Team MVPs, followed by 92 Ultra, a 93 Ultra, and a 91 Upper Deck. So that does it for my Alan Trammell cards. I think it's like 35 cards total I have of Alan Trammell. So yeah, I got plenty of room for my Alan Trammell collection to grow. But like, you know, I don't really chase cards, and collecting Hall of Famers, there's so many players you got to collect. I just take what comes across my desk and goes into the binder. I'm a go with the flow collector, you know. I've always said that I was a go with the flow collector. Don't really chase. But yeah, so that was my Binder Bites for the day. I don't want to ramble too much or it wouldn't be bite-sized. We try to keep these short, one player at a time. If I got smaller collections with, you know, only a few cards for the player, I might do two players. And then some players, I got a lot of guards. You know, some players I got, you know, 100, close to 200 cards for, which isn't huge. You know, a lot of you collectors out there have huge collections of players. But, you know, I just like my unfocused floating on the raft collecting isn't really conducive to getting a whole lot of cards of one player at a time. But yeah, I appreciate everybody watching. Remember, you can only control two things, that's your thoughts and your actions. So stay positive, keep ripping the packs, keep filling up the binders, and yeah, don't let the eBay comps determine your enjoyment of the hobby. And I'll catch you all later. Peace.